Albuquerque police have released the name of the officer involved in this weekend's fatal pedestrian accident.
And this is not the first time Officer Aaron Zwicky has been linked to a death on the job. Action 7 News reporter Ana Velasquez is here to explain.
Doug and Shelley, APD officials say Officer Aaron Zwicky could not have avoided pedestrian Patrick Dennison as Officer Zwicky was responding to an urgent call. But that same officer was involved in a shooting in 2010 involving a dangerous kidnapper.
The officer's obviously very shook up.
Chief Ray Schultz spoke with Action 7 News early Sunday morning after one of his officers hit and killed a pedestrian on Central near Coors. Investigators say the person was in dark clothing, not in a crosswalk, and jumped out in front of 39-year-old Officer Aaron Zwicky's patrol car. This is the second time in his five-year career with APD that Officer Zwicky has been in a deadly situation.
Got shot fired. Full male subject.
In June of 2010, surveillance video captured the split-second life and death moments when Officer Aaron Zwicky confronted Julian Calbert at the Flying J on 98th and I-40. Calbert kidnapped his ex-girlfriend and her friend at knife point. The officer sees blood on the trunk of the car. He orders the suspect to open it, and that's when Julian Calbert turns around and lunges at Officer Zwicky's throat with a pocket knife. Zwicky grabs his gun and fires three rounds. Calbert falls to the ground, still holding the knife. That friend tells Action 7 News Officer Zwicky arrived within minutes of the call and saved their lives.
He charged at the officer with the knife. If he could have killed him, he would have killed him. He would have got in the car, stabbed me to death, popped the trunk and killed him. You know, he saved three lives.
Police say Officer Zwicky wasn't put on leave after the New Year's Eve accident because he was scheduled for 3 days off anyway, and he will return to patrol tomorrow.
Police say at this time it's not known if the pedestrian, 57-year-old Patrick Dennison, was intoxicated, but the police report indicates he was at